Latter-day Trumpet. This is a Latter-day Trumpet presentation that is an exciting new video about the Book of Mormon. There are many church scholars that believe that the Lehi colony landed in South America. This series of videos reflect those ideas and theories and should not be considered as official church doctrine. The Tree of Life, Part 2, by L. Norman Shurtleff. In the first vision, our Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ appeared to the young boy Joseph Smith. This wonderful event at the base of a tree in the sacred grove near Joseph's home in western New York ushered in the last dispensation and commenced the restoration of the gospel in these the latter days. Trees have always been important to us, both physically and spiritually, from the beginning, even since Adam and Eve. The two sacred trees of the knowledge of good and evil and the tree of eternal life are good examples. We can find other examples from the Book of Mormon and South America of the importance of trees. Here on the southern coast of Peru is found the Nazca line of the Tree of Life, with its fruit, therefore, guiding ancient mariners to their home port. The symbol of the Tree of Life, carved on the hillside, forever guided their boats home, and they would never be lost in the Sea of Life. In the city of Ollantaytambo, there are also found some fantastic ancient ruins that the people carved into the landscape to give them direction in life. The mountain Pincajana, overlooking the city itself, is an ancient solar calendar that told them what time of year it was and when to plant, etc., based on the sun's rising or cresting over the top of the mountain at different locations pertaining to the time of year. Beneath the mountain, on the valley floor, was laid out a beautiful tree that was incredibly symbolic. This huge Tree of Life symbol was built anciently by the Incas to remind them of their origin and purposes in life. The trunk of the tree reached its roots into the deep mountainous ravines, while a river runs from the roots through the trunk of the tree, splitting it in two, symbolizing energy and sustenance that we receive through our roots, carrying water and nutrition throughout our whole. One side of the tree was a male and the other side was female, symbolizing the union with our spouse to become a whole entity. The split tree was connected and unified in everything that it does. The miracle was that this union became the complete tree, with its branches bearing the fruit of our labors and children. The Spanish chroniclers of the 16th century discovered that these people had knowledge of the creation and Adam and Eve. They theorized in their writing that the split tree symbolized mother and father, and named them Marisaco and Sutasaco. In this ideogram from the 16th century, the chronicler is trying to explain this important Inca diagram of the Tree of Life. A split tree has great religious and sacred significance to the Incas. Usually a tree is split like this one due to damage of some kind. The damage can come from a lightning strike, disease, or something else. But to the Inca, it was revered because of the fact that the tree had overcome its difficulties and still stayed together and flourished. Here is a picture of the Ollantaytambo Valley with the Pyramid of Caratampu and its two windows. The Calendar Mountain contained the face of Wiracochan, or Jesus Christ, carved into the side of the mountain, and it is part of the Tree of Life. The city itself is laid out in the form of a cob of corn. The whole valley is a magnificent recreation of the Tree of Life and the symbolisms of the things that are important in our own individual lives. Here's an artist's rendition or diagram of the Tree of Life and all of the important attributes of the sacred valley of Ollantaytambo. On the other side of the tree trunk are magnificent ruins that were made in the form of two llamas that terraced the hillside, which signified the importance of growing their crops and tending their herds. On top of the hill is a fantastic temple built of gigantic stones. On the opposite side is Mount Pincajana, with the carving of Wiracochan, or Jesus Christ, within clear view of the city below. At the top of the tree, was the pyramid and terraces for special crops at the very top or crown of the tree. Here's an enlarged view of the pyramid of Paccaritampu. The pyramid only rises a few feet on each level, and it is more like a crop terrace than a traditional pyramid that we see in other parts of the world. It is unique because of the fact that it is built using useful and irrigated farmland. In the foreground, you can see the two windows of the pyramid that are quite unique as well with their terraced construction. These two windows form a beautiful solar calendar as well. At the equinox of each year, then a sliver or stream of light from the sun shines through the mountains at the opposite side of the valley to illuminate the windows. It is a very remarkable man-made phenomenon built by these ancient agrarian Incas to help them know when to plant, when the rainy season would come, to harvest, etc. It is absolutely amazing and an incredible aspect of their tree of life. Another important symbol that is probably the focal point of Ojeite Tambo and most incredible is the carving of Wiracocha. On the side of the mountain just above the city, the ancient inhabitants carved the face of Jesus Christ, our Savior. It is a huge carving of Wiracocha, the great high priest, who went about the towns and cities healing the sick and preaching the gospel, giving out the good gifts that he carried on his back. Every day at 2 o'clock, a stream of sunlight from the opposite valley shines on his eyes and he awakens, thus helping the people remember him on a daily basis, knowing that Wiracocha loves and remembers them. Here is an artist's rendition of the mountain carving. You can see clearly the heavy burden of gifts that the Savior carried on his back to give out to all those who believed on him. There are many symbolisms then of the Tree of Life. One of the most famous is the Tree of Life vision that the prophet Lehi had in the Book of Mormon. It has great significance to us who believe in the Book of Mormon. In the Stela 5 stone from Chiapas, Mexico, the Lehi stone, we can see the ancient people believed in this vision and revered it greatly and painstakingly carved it into the stone stela to make a permanent record of it. Here's an actual picture of the 6-foot replica of the Lehi stone that is found at BYU. The carving is beautiful and features the prophet Lehi sitting at the base of the tree teaching his children. Figure number 7 in this artist's drawing is the prophet Lehi. This vision of the Tree of Life becomes a model for our lives, just like it was for the ancient inhabitants of the Americas. The prophet Lehi described the fruit of the tree, or the love of God, as desirable to make one happy. And it came to pass that I did go forth and partake of the fruit thereof. And I beheld that it was most sweet above all that I had ever before tasted. Yea, and I beheld that the fruit thereof was white, to exceed all the whiteness that I had ever before seen. And as I partook of the fruit thereof, it filled my soul with exceeding great joy. Wherefore, I began to be desirous that my family should partake of it also, for I knew that it was desirable above all other fruit. In the last days there are but few that find the straight and narrow path and grab hold of the rod of iron with all of their might. We march on toward the beautiful tree of life, with all the world pointing the finger of scorn at us. But when we taste of the precious fruit, it truly is most sweet, and it fills our souls with exceeding great joy. It is the ultimate allegory of our sojourn in our mortal lives. Another example is seen here in this picture of the prophet Moses. The artist painted the burning bush to be more like a small tree through which the Lord spoke to Moses. The real point here is that this spot on top of Mount Sinai became forever sacred after this event. And the Lord said, "Moses, Moses." And he said, "Here am I." And he said, "Draw not nigh hither. Put off thy shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground." Clearly, the most sacred of all these places would be the Garden of Gethsemane. where the Savior of the world paid the ultimate sacrifice for us and atoned for the sins of all mankind. Among those olive trees in the garden, Jesus Christ knelt and prayed to our Father in heaven. Not only did he talk with God, but angels were also present to buoy him up and witness in this grove of trees. This is the greatest event in the history of the world. The ancient olive trees in the garden today would have been witnesses of this sacred event 2,000 years ago. A person can feel the spirit that this sacred grove of trees emanates even today. In the Book of Mormon, Nephi says, "And I, Nephi, saw that he was lifted up upon the cross and slain for the sins of the world." In the Bible, Acts 5, verse 30 is quoted as follows, "The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree." The cross in this scripture is referred to as a tree. Obviously, the wooden beams making up the cross were hewn from a tree. But, moreover, there is symbolism of the Savior finishing his mortal life on a tree. In conclusion, we all need to find our sacred grove of trees where we can communicate with God also. It may be our closet or our bedroom, or it can be a special place that we have made sacred. We can receive our own personal revelation that will aid us in our journey along the straight and narrow path to the tree of life. How sweet will be the fruit of the tree of eternal life when we partake of it.